Chairman and committee members, thank you so much. My name is Dr. Timothy Flanagan. I'm an HIV and infectious disease doctor. Been here in Rhode Island since 1991. I practice mostly at the Miriam Hospital and at Rhode Island Hospital. And I provided end-of-life care to my patients really during my entire 30 years. Just last week on Monday, I was with a patient of mine who was in hospice care at North Main Street, who unfortunately passed away the next day. I'm here to testify against this bill. One reason that people support this bill, and we heard some of it before, was due to severe pain. And pain at end of life, as we know, is so common. The advances in pain medication over the last 10 and 15 years has been extraordinary. There are still times where patients will have intractable pain despite all of our prescribed medications, which hospice care and palliative medicine physicians are so good at. In that case, we now have available to us palliative sedation, which is where pain can absolutely be treated, even though that does have an impact on that person. So this has only been available in the last few years. So the advances in pain treatment is really new and changes this landscape. Now, unfortunately, at the end of life, there's another type of pain, and that's the pain that comes from losing your ability to enjoy the things you love so much. You lose your independence. You do sometimes become a burden. You do often lose your dignity because you can't care for yourself with severe degenerative diseases, cancer, and so forth. And with that comes depression. We call this reactive depression. It's normal. It's not an organic depression separate. It's normal. It's so common that we consider it part of the normal process. When somebody is depressed, it's normal for them to want to give up, for them to want to end their life, for them to want to short circuit this process and end it early. And yet, with someone with depression, that's when you are most vulnerable. And unfortunately, to offer and then to propose in a very nice way, physician-assisted death, physician-assisted suicide, is such a disservice when people are most vulnerable. And I think it is very destructive. It's destructive for the medical profession, where our first goal is to care. It's destructive to patients when they're most vulnerable, and it's destructive to families when they are also most vulnerable with a family member near the end of life. So I want to be on record to oppose this bill.
Thank you. Any questions of the doctor? Yes. Rep. Perez.
Hey, thank you for coming. I understand the doctor have an oath, right?
If you go back to the Hippocratic Oath,
yes.
2,000 years ago, part of that oath was that you cannot prescribe a potion to quicken death. So physician-assisted suicide, physician-assisted death, was prohibited by the Hippocratic Oath. That is, obviously, that's an oath that physicians over the centuries have taken, but we don't currently take that oath because there's mixed opinions in the medical profession regarding this.
I ask you because my family was in a situation that my baby died, and we asked the doctor to provide more help to the baby maybe survive. And what his answer was, I have an O. I don't want to prolong life or suffering. But by you allowing the baby to die, you don't really up to your O, right? And that's my point.
Yeah. I'm sorry for you and for your loss with this. And we are always obliged to treat and treat suffering and decrease pain.
Thank you. Any other questions? Thank you, Doctor.